Welcome back to Living Black, coming to you from Perth. A group of teenagers from Roebourne, Western Australia, have taken their passion for comic books into the digital age. They've created Australia's first Aboriginal interactive comic. Letitia Griffin has more.
Quiet, quiet, Dad!
It's the year 2076.
Neomads, a futuristic film about 15 young Aboriginal teenagers in the year 2076, called the Love Punks.
Freeze the animals, gone!
Radiation has destroyed the land and the fate of the world rests in their hands. This story has now been transformed into the first ever Aboriginal digital comic book.
The last people to roam the earth are flesh eating cannibals!
Made in collaboration with the Jalayala Project, Big Art and the youth of Roebourne, this initiative is the first of its kind in Australia. A zombie film, music videos, an online game, and now a digital comic book. For these young Photoshop enthusiasts, their work just keeps getting bigger.
I know how to do the brush tool, the eyedropper, the paint bucket, and know how to create a new layer.
For 12-year-old Nathaniel Edwins, Photoshop has become a much-loved hobby. He even dreams about it.
I had this dream doing about Photoshop that I was doing Photoshop and these people came to have a look and they took pictures and they asked me if I can go to New York and do some colouring.
And Nathaniel's dream has become a reality. He's been invited to South Korea for the International Comic Book Festival, where he'll present Neomad to the rest of the world. The 60 full-colour page digital comic has it all. Interactivity, animation, music and sound effects. Its aim is to share the rich Aboriginal culture of the Pilbara Desert region.
I'm gonna eat you.
Ah, don't eat me.
The project has also been a personal journey for the students, who've undergone a noticeable transformation.
Do you have any faith in humanity?
It brought a lot of boldness within them, even to sit and speak and even to perform. And I've never seen any kids like that in my days. Aboriginal kids are very shy. But these kids, they played a great role and it made me proud to see what they have done this day.
You can show it, you can like erase a bit of your glasses, eye drop the colour.
For artist and project coordinator Stuart Campbell, hosting workshops and meeting the kids of Roebourne has been a life-changing experience.
It's the most interesting sort of comic project that I've ever been involved in. Usually I don't have real life subjects to draw from. What we've really tried to do, I've been hanging out here and living in Roebourne for a year now, and I know these little guys pretty well. And they've got amazing personalities, and we've tried to pull those personalities into the comic as much as possible.
And it's these personalities that shine through the iPad comic screen.
Every day after school, we had to get picked up from these guys. And we get costumes on, and sometimes we have to read our script.
The first comic episode shows Love Punk leader Gurawara teaching his culture. With stories like this, it's more than a comic book. It's an educational tool, inspiring these young teens to draw upon their personal life experiences.
So about this one person, and he gets shocked from a lightning and he gets the power.
The digital comic book is now available on iTunes, and for the teenagers of Roebourne, it's sure to be a hit.